I'm Gustavo Turecki. I'm a psychiatrist, a professor in the Department of Psychiatry at McGill, and a scientist at the Douglas Institute, where I'm also the scientific director. The Ludmer Centre has been an initiative between McGill, the Douglas Institute, the Neuro, and the Lady Davis Institute at the Jewish General Hospital. It began initially bringing together a few scientists interested in brain imaging and in epigenetics, as well as in analytical methods. There has been an opportunity to expand the Ludmer Center into the single cell genomics. Single cell technology, it's a way to actually interrogate every cell at a high throughput manner. You're able to basically understand what's going on at the level of the cell in a tissue all at once. Doing single cell genomics is a way to deconstruct what's going on at the most basic element, which is the cell. For tissues like the brain, where we don't understand very much how it works, there's still a lot of important questions to be addressed. By interrogating each cell in a part of the brain, it would bring us new opportunities, will generate a lot of new insight into how the brain works. The Douglas Institute, it's an institute focused on mental illness. What we bring to the Ludmer Center is that expertise, is the understanding, studying, and helping patients with mental illnesses. In particular to the single cell genomics, the Douglas Brain Bank, it's a unique resource. Unfortunately, we cannot have access to brain tissue from living individuals. We have 4,000 brains, approximately, from individuals who died from psychiatric illnesses, who died by suicide, affected with dementia, with Parkinson's disease, as well as from individuals who died from car accidents or died by a heart attack, because we also need brains that were not affected with brain disorders in order to be able to compare. We need to understand both how the normal brain works and also how the brain of individuals who had psychiatric disorders, neurological disorders, tumors, and what happens that led to those disorders. The Brain Bank collects brain tissue from individuals from Quebec, primarily from the larger Montreal region. So it's representative of the population that lives here. So we have brains from all age groups, from all socioeconomic classes, from all demographic, to be as representative as possible. Obviously, it's determined by the will of the people to make a donation. So the Brain Bank is open to the scientific community. We send approximately 1,000 samples across the world from the Brain Bank for researchers interested in studying a number of different things related to the brain. There are not many other brain banks around the world, so we are frequently asked by researchers everywhere, so from the United States to Europe to Japan. It's a resource that helps really advance neuroscience and advance knowledge on how the brain works. We have a policy of open science, have adopted it, and we are committed to its principles. So we are working to build a platform that will connect the Brain Bank and the data that's produced as part of the Brain Bank to a database that will be open to the scientific community. So not only by sending tissue to labs, but also making the results of the experiment that were generated using the tissue available to the scientific community. at the Douglas Institute. We have collaborations at the institutional level, like the one through the Ludmer, for instance, with the Neuro and the Lady Davis. We also have partnership with other institutes. Every single lab here all have their own collaborations, at their own lab level. I think that we are all very ambitious and we want to eventually develop interventions, treatments, to be able to help people who are affected with brain diseases. So I think that this new initiative of the Ludmer Center will really make a big step in that direction. Hopefully to the point of actually allowing for intervention helping people, but just by advancing knowledge and understanding how the brain works, it's to me, it's a big step.